Welcome to Laexcellence. Today we are going to have a session on questions of the week, December 2nd to December 8th. We will be discussing for the first 1 week incidents. Our main agenda is to accumulate the knowledge and have a peripheral area how the questions may ask in the exams. The prelims perspective, and our aim is to avoid some silly mistakes in the final exam, and we have to practice as many questions as possible. First, we will start with the topic B.R. Ambedkar. We can study this topic in modern history and polity perspective. This taken from the PIB and why it is in the news. Recently, 63rd Mahaparinirvana Divas, that is death anniversary, December 6th, our President Sri Ramnath Kovindji paid homage. On this occasion, let's practice one question. Which of the following true regarding the B.R. Ambedkar? Here, first statement is Chaitya Bhumi, the cremation located in central Mumbai. The second statement says Samata Sainik Dal, an organization founded by Ambedkar. So here both the statements are correct, and we have to remember Samata Sainik Dal, it is a voluntary organization founded by the Ambedkar, and we have to remember the Chaitya Bhumi, where it is located in the exam point of view. Here let's add some few points regarding Chaitya Bhumi, and it is a memorial to the B.R. Ambedkar, and he died on the 1956 December 6th, and this was opened on 5th December 1971. The place is Mumbai. Let's practice another question. Which of the following true regarding the Ambedkar? The first statement is he was the first Minister of Law and Justice, and second statement he was the labor member of the Viceroy Executive Council. So here both the statements are correct. He is first Minister of Law and Justice. He is in the office 1947 to 1951, and also he is the labor member of the Viceroy Executive Council from 1942 to 1946. Let's practice another question. Which of the following parties related to the B.R. Ambedkar? So first statement is Scheduled Caste Federation, second one is Independent Labour Party, and third one is Republic Party of India. So all the statements are correct. So in the exam point of view, you have to remember that all these parties are related to B.R. Ambedkar. And here we have to remember that he got Bharat Ratna after posthumous in 1990. Let's discuss another topic, that is Qatar. We can study this topic in international issues and international bodies also. First of all, Qatar, why it is in the news? Qatar recently quit from the OPEC, that will be effect from the January 1st, 2019. So in the exam point of view, we have to study geographical location, where it is Qatar is located, and also international point of view, how this is impact to the India in the mains perspective or interest perspective. In this map, we can see the exact location where it is Qatar is located. So let's discuss what is exactly the issue. So here, some of the countries like Saudi Arabia and along with other countries, they are accusing Qatar that Qatar is supporting the terrorism. Due to this reason, June 2017, the Saudi Arabia and other three countries, they cut the trade relation and transport ties with the Qatar. If we see the Qatar, the neighbor is Saudi Arabia, and here UAE is there, and here Bahrain is there. So UAE, Saudi Arabia and Bahrain and Egypt, these they cut the trade relation and ties with the Qatar in June 5, 2017. Also it impacted the diplomatic contacts with the Doha, Qatar. Try to stop the airlines and land border and port to the Qatar. Here if you talk about the oil reserves of the Qatar, it is the smallest oil producing country in the world. It is one of the largest producer of the liquefied natural gas. So here, in terms of area, it is the smallest country, but in terms of per capita gross national income, it is the richest nation, and its per capita gross national income is 90 lakh. If we talk about the OPEC countries, it produces 45% of the world oil and contains 80% of the reserves. Here we can see Qatar, its capital is Doha, and its borders are, you can see the Saudi Arabia and UAE. And here Persian Gulf is there. There is a Bahrain island. Its capital is Manama. So let's practice question related to Qatar. Which are the following true regarding Qatar? And its first statement is it is border with the Saudi Arabia, Bahrain and UAE. And the second statement is Persian Gulf is bordered with the Qatar. And third statement is founding member of the OPEC. So here only second statement is correct and first statement is wrong, because Bahrain is island, it is not bordered, and Qatar is not the founding member. In 1960 OPEC was found, and in 1961 Qatar was joined in this. So here correct option is B. So you can see here Qatar bordered with Saudi Arabia and UAE, and OPEC was formed in 1960 by Saudi Arabia, Iraq, Iran, Kuwait and Venezuela. Later Qatar in 1961 joined.
In the mains perspective or interview perspective, here how it will impact on India by departing from the OPEC, Qatar. Here Qatar has limited influence on OPEC's price decision. It is mostly LNG exporter, 77 million tons per day production of the LNG. So India is one of the importer of the LNG supplier from the Qatar. But here LNG pricing is not in the OPEC's domain. So there will not be a much impact on India.
So OPEC, when it was established and who are the members, let's see. So in 1960 it was established, and here there are 15 countries we can see. In the South America, Ecuador and Venezuela, and in the Africa, Angola, Gabon, Equatorial Guinea and Republic of Congo, and Nigeria, Algeria, Libya. And in the West Asia, Kuwait, Iraq, Iran, Qatar, Saudi Arabia, UAE. So here Qatar will be quitting from the OPEC. And earlier Indonesia was member to OPEC, but it withdrawn from that earlier. So let's practice one question regarding OPEC. So Organization of Petroleum and Exporting Country, its full form. And first statement is, it is a group of oil producing nation. Its headquarter is Baghdad, Iraq. And second statement is, currently organization has total 15 member countries. And third statement is, Indonesia is a former member and Qatar will be no longer starting from 1st January 2019. Here first statement only wrong and remaining are correct. Here Baghdad was the first headquarter, later it was shifted to Geneva, Switzerland, and then to diplomatic issues it was changed to Vienna, Austria capital. So here first remember the headquarter is Vienna, capital of Austria.
So here 1965 onwards Vienna, Austria is the headquarter.
If we talk about the share of the oil reserves according to the 2017 report, so Venezuela is 25% share is there, and next 22% Saudi Arabia. These two we have to remember. Later Iran, Iraq 13%, 12%, and Kuwait 8%, UAE 8%, Libya 4%, Nigeria 3%, and here news Qatar is 2% only, so it's negligible. And remaining all Algeria, Angola, Ecuador, Gabon, Equator, Guinea, most insignificant. According to the report, 82% of the oils proved oil reserves are in this OPEC member countries only. And in this Middle East, it is covering 65% almost.
Let's discuss another topic, French Guinea, why it is in the news. Recently, India's heaviest satellite, GSAT-11, was launched from this Ariana space rocket from the French Guinea. So now we can study this in the GS3 paper, Science and Technology, and also geographical perspective where French Guinea is located. So here French Guinea is located in the South America, and here nearby we can see Suriname, Guyana and Brazil. These are the neighbor countries nearby, and other we know Venezuela, Colombia, Ecuador, Peru, Brazil, Bolivia, Paraguay, Uruguay, Argentina. So the many countries are ruled by European nation. Now here we can see they have different languages. Guyana speaks English, and then Suriname speaks Dutch, and then French Guiana speaks French, and Brazil is Portuguese and Spanish in other areas. That means these countries were ruled by the many European countries.
So here if you see French Guiana, its capital is Kene, and Suriname capital is Paramaribo, Guyana is capital is Georgetown, and Venezuela capital is Caracas.
So let's practice one question. Which of the following statements true regarding GSAT-11? Because GSAT-11 was launched from the French Guiana. So here first statement is GSAT-11 is the heaviest satellite. It is built by the ISRO. And the second statement is the next generation high output communication satellites configured with the I6K bus. And the third statement, it has designed lifetime more than 15 years. So here all the statements are correct. All the statements are correct. After forced separation and launch successfully, ISRO's master control facility is located at Hassan in Karnataka. It will take over the command and control of the GSAT-11. Let's discuss another topic, Katowice, Poland. So why it is in the news? Conference of Parties 24 was started recently. 2 weeks conference held in Katowice, Poland. So now we can study this topic in GS3, Environment in the climate change topic. And also we have to study in the geographical perspective Poland and where it is located, Katowice. We'll try to know regarding Poland and its geographical location of Katowice. So its capital is Warsaw, and its neighbor countries, if we see here, Germany is there, and Czech Republic, and Slovakia, and Ukraine, Belarus, and Russia, and Lithuania. So here Katowice is a small city in Poland. This place has rich coal reserves. Katowice is in southern region of the Poland, and there are mountain regions also there. That's why here coal reserves are there. Let's practice one question regarding this. Which of the following true regarding Katowice, Poland? Katowice is the seat of Polish National Radio Symphony and Orchestra. Second statement, Katowice joined UNESCO Creative Cities Network and named a UNESCO City of Music. So both the statements are correct. So here 2015 it joined in UNESCO City of Music because of its famous orchestra. Go through physical map of the Poland. Here Polish plains are there and Poland uplands are there. Here Sudetes mountains are there and Beskids mountains also there. In the northern side Baltic Sea is there. So let's practice one question. Which of the following true regarding Poland? So already we have discussed that Germany, Czech Republic, Slovakia, Ukraine, Belarus, Lithuania all are, and Russia is all are border to the Poland. So all the statements are correct. So this is the geographical perspective and the technical perspective. Conference of Parties 24 started December 3 to 14, December 14, 2 weeks conference. So regarding this, which of the following true regarding the United Nations Climate Change Convention, UNFCC. So your first statement is it is started in Katowice, Poland, and second statement is started with a special focus on carbon neutrality and gender equality. And third statement is parties of the UNFCC gathering to negotiate the Paris Agreement to work program. So here all the statements are correct, and please remember the focus on carbon neutrality and gender equality. And please remember 2015 Paris Agreement COP22 held. Under this agreement, all the countries committed to reduce greenhouse gases well below 2 degrees centigrade in pre-industrial level. So let's practice one question. Which of the following true regarding COP23? So now presently COP24 is going on. That means last year where it was related that question. So last year it was held in Paris, and third statement, Talanova dialogue is a significant outcome of the COP22. So here second statement only correct, because here COP23 was held in Bonn, Germany last year. And here we have to remember Talanova dialogue is related to outcome of the COP23, and we will try to know what is the Talanova dialogue. So here correct option is B, and Talanova dialogue is a Fijian word which represents the idea of inclusive and participatory and transparent dialogue that should lead to the decision adoptions for the public good. So here Talanova dialogue is said to begin early 2018, and it will be concluded in this present COP24. So the word is related to Fiji country, that is small island nation, because there are many island nations are extremely vulnerable to the climate change. So there is a need to address this. Next here, United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change, UNFCC. Here we'll try to know little. It was adopted, it is an international environmental treaty adopted in 1992 when Earth Summits were held in Rio de Janeiro, 1992. But it came into force 1994 only after ratifying many countries. Presently there are 165 signatories. Here condition is ratified, minimum 50 countries should ratify to come into effect this framework. So presently 165 countries are there out of 197 United Nations countries. So if we talk about the UNFCCC main objective, its main objective is to stabilize the greenhouse gases, and presently in the atmosphere greenhouse gas concentration level is increasing due to anthropogenic interference. So here conference of parties, they meet and they try to deal with the climate change, and they'll try to address the progress of the countries committed to take the actions. From 1995 onwards, the UNFCCC conference was started meeting. In the 1997, there was a Kyoto Protocol. This was concluded. It became legally binding obligation and developed countries to reduce their greenhouse gases emission by 2012. Kyoto Protocol, it already time got expired, so recently they amended. They extended the period 2013 to 2020 in the Doha Amendment in 2015. In 2015, there was a Paris Agreement adopted to reduce the greenhouse gas reduction from 2020. So here we have to remember that this Paris Agreement came into force November 4, 2016. So here all the countries are committed having nationally determined contributions to reduce the greenhouse gases. Here the first task set by the UNFCCC is that signatory nations, they have to establish the greenhouse gas inventories of greenhouse gases emissions and its removals. So here annex countries are there, they are industrially developed countries and they have to update the inventories annually. Next topic is Hornbill Festival. So we can study this topic in GS1 history in the culture perspective. So why it is in the news? So Union Home Minister recently inaugurated the Horn Festival in Kohima, Nagaland capital. It is coincided with the formation of Nagaland Formation Day. So we have taken from the PIB, Press Information Bureau. So we can see here unique tradition of Nagaland. Also we can see the hornbill bird. It has its own uniqueness for this bird, having its great alertness. So let's practice one question. Which of the following true regarding the Hornbill Festival? The first statement is Nagaland celebrates this festival to revive and protect the sustain and promote the richness of the Naga heritage and traditions. Second statement is Hornbill Festival was established on December 1st, 1963. It was inaugurated by the President Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan. So both the statements are correct. Every year they celebrate 1st December to 10th December annual basis, and it is also called Festivals of the Festival, and it is organized by the State Tourism and Art Culture Departments and also supported by the Union Government. This festival pays tributes to the hornbill. It has unique qualities for alertness and grandeur. So let's discuss G20 Summit. Last week we have discussed G20 Summit. So here 2020 we will be celebrating 75th year of independence. On this occasion we will be hosting the G20 Summit. We have to remember this in the exam point of view. And remaining things, when it was established and all those things we have discussed in the earlier last. So let's practice one question regarding G20 Summit. India will host G20 Summit 2022, and that is the 75th year of the independence. Second statement is, it will be the first meet of the global grouping in India. It will be the G20. So both the statements are correct. Here next topic is SEMAN. What is this? SEMAN, its full form is Crew Interactive Mobile Companion. It is a small robot endowed with the artificial intelligence. It is launched for 2-day trip to the International Space Station. It was by SpaceX Dragon cargo capsule. So this robot, is its objective is to assist the astronauts conducting experiments in the International Space Station. So this is already sent in June 15. Why we are remembering this? Because by December 13 it will be returning to the Earth. So now we can study this in the GS3 Science and Technology part, and we have taken this from the Hindustan Times. So let's practice one question regarding this. Which of the following two regarding SEMAN, that is Crew Interactive Mobile Companion? So first statement is, it is a small robot endowed with artificial intelligence, and second statement is, it is launched a 2-day trip to the International Space Station. Now that we will learn about what is it. It is aboard by the SpaceX Dragon cargo capsule, and third statement is, it was launched by the NASA. So here the correct option is A. So here it is not developed by the NASA. It is developed by the European aerospace company Airbus on behalf of German Space Agency. That's why it is wrong, and remaining two are correct. Correct answer is A. It is developed by the European aerospace company Airbus on behalf of the German Space Agency. And robot is having artificial intelligence. It is a technology is given by the IBM company. And this robot is only having 5 cages. It's a football size. It is having facial recognition software. So SEMAN is said to be inspired by the 1960s science fiction comic series set in the space. So its main aim is to support and increase the astronauts' efficiency, helping the experiments to the astronauts. What it will do, it will give the mobile photography and videography and ability to having some search for documents and maintain inventory. Let's discuss another topic, that is the International Day of Persons with Disabilities. We can study in GS1 social issues part, and we have taken this from the PIB. So what is the, why it is in the International Day of Persons with Disabilities observed in every year on December 3rd. So to promote rights and well-being of the persons with the disabilities in all society and development for them, and to support the dignity. Let's practice one question. Which of the following true regarding the International Day of the Persons with Disability. It was instituted by the United Nations General Assembly in 1992, and the present 2018 theme is Empowering Persons with Disability and Ensuring Inclusiveness and Equality. So both the statements are correct. So persons with disability having many schemes also government launched, that is Disha and Vikas and Samrat. Here go group home for adults, that is Garundwa, and health insurance scheme Niramaya, and caregiver training scheme Sayogi. For educational support, Jnan Prabha, and marketing assistance, Prerana, and aids and assistant devices, Sambhava. Let's discuss another topic, that is exceeds at one. So we can study this topic in GS3, Science and Technology, Space Technology part, and we are taken from the Hindu, and why it is in the news. Recently launched exceeds at, this is the first Indian private funded startup successfully sent to into space. What is this all satellite about? It is launched by the SpaceX, not the ISRO. It is having 63 other satellites from 17 countries. So it is a mini communication satellite. It serves for the radio community and its lifetime is 5 years. Atlas is a big boost to the private radio operators and also helps coordinate messages among them and help in country in time of disasters. So here let's talk about the Falcon and SpaceX. So Falcon is a two-stage to orbit medium lift launch vehicle designed by the SpaceX only. It is a US company, private based space company. It is burning with the liquid oxygen and rocket grade kerosene propellants. And here SpaceX is a space exploration technology corporation. It is a private American space manufacturing and space transportation service company. It is headquartered in the California. So let's talk about another topic, World Soil Day. So we can study this in the geography perspective, that is GS1, and taken from the Hindu. Why it is in the news? Recently, 5th December, we celebrated World Soil Day, and with the initiation of Food and Agriculture Organization of the United Nations body. So its main aim is to communicate and give some importance to the soil quality for the food security and a healthy ecosystem and human well-being. So its theme is Be Solution to the Soil Pollution. Let's discuss another topic, Amaravati. It is the capital of Andhra Pradesh. Why it is in this? Andhra Pradesh to have a separate high court in the next year. That will be the 25th high court. So far it is a common high court. Hyderabad is a common high court for the Andhra Pradesh and Telangana. And this topic we can study in the polity, judiciary part. Let's solve the one question. Which of the following true regarding the high courts? So Calcutta High Court is the oldest established high court, 1862. And the second statement is Andhra Pradesh High Court will be the 24th and latest High Court in India. So here only one statement is correct. The second statement is wrong because it is the 25th High Court. Here answer is A. Andhra Pradesh to have a separate High Court, that will be the 25th. Please remember this. For the other competitive exams, apart from civil services, maybe group 1 or other exams, you have to remember like these facts also. Let's solve another miscellaneous questions last week. Recently, China halted the work on gene editing babies. Why the scientists altered the DNA of the twin girls? So first statement is DNA altered to prevent the cancer, DNA altered to prevent the heart disease, DNA altered to prevent the mental illness, DNA altered to prevent the contracting HIV. So your correct option is HIV. Let's solve another question. ICFT UNESCO Gandhi Award will be given to. So ITFC means International Council for Film, Television and Audiovisual Communication. UNESCO Award. So first statement is the award is given for the countries working to promote peace and harmony. Second statement is for social service in village panchayats for persons working with to promote Gandhian ideals. Fourth one is it is given for the film that best reflects the Mahatma Gandhi's ideals of peace, tolerance and non-violence. So here the correct option is D. So this award will be announced at the closing ceremony of IFFI. So that is International Film Festival of India, recently held in Goa. That is the 49th International Film Festival. Bhumidala, why it is in the news? Recently there was incident in the Bhumidala. This is located in the Arunachal Pradesh. Recently two soldiers of the Indian Army were arrested by the local police and reportedly beaten up for alleged incorrect behavior. So this we can study in the internal security, taken from the Hindu. So internal security, this is GS3. And also we can study from the geography perspective, Bhumidala is in news, so we have to study it in the geographical location where it is located. Here Indian Army is involved, so here APSPA Act is there, that also we have to study. You can see Bhumidala is located in Arunachal Pradesh, southern region. So it is a small institution of out of 60 constituencies in Arunachal Pradesh, and we have to remember few things. That is, average elevation is 2415 meter elevation, and we have to remember the inhabited tribes here: Monpa, Serdukhenfen, Mizi, Begun, Oka tribes. These are the tribes. In this contest, two Indian army were arrested by the local police. So already Indian army forces, they have the Armed Forces Special Powers Act 1958. This act given some special powers immunity to the armed forces. So here question is, who has the power to invoke a place as a disturbed area? But so the central government has the power to declare as a disturbed area, governor has the power, and administrator of the union territory, and anyone of the above. So anyone of the above is the correct answer. So your correct option is D. So section 3 of the OPSPA given the power to the governor of the state or union territory to issue a official notification for the declaring the state or a particular region as a disturbed area. Once it is declared, the message will go to the central government, and central government will decide whether to send the armed forces or not. Next question we will solve related to this topic. Which of the following states are currently under the OPSPA Act? So all the northeastern states are under OPSPA Act, and second statement is Jammu Kashmir. So here correct statement is 2 only. So this is not, because Meghalaya, Tripura and some districts of the Arunachal Pradesh were removed from the OPSPA because of free from the insurgency groups because of good administration and other activities. The correct option is B. In the exam perspective, we have to remember that. So which countries are not come under the OPSPA Act? So recently Meghalaya, Tripura, some parts of the Arunachal Pradesh were declared as free of insurgency. That's why they are not come under the OPSPA Act. Let's discuss the another topics. POCSO Act 2012. What is a POCSO? POCSO is Protection of Children from Sexual Offences in 2012. So we can study this in the GS2 part, in the government policies for vulnerable groups. So why it is in the news? Recently Supreme Court told to CBI that take over the case investigation related to sexual abuse. The incidence is sexual attacks on inmates of the 17 sheltered homes in Bihar. So Bihar police, they lagged the probing the incidents. That's why Supreme Court said CBI that take over the investigation. In this regard, in the men's perspective, we can study some of the provisions of the POSCO Act 2012. So what these main provisions, we can see that. So it defined the 18 year below, he is a child, and there will be a death penalty for raping a child up to 12 years, and minimum punishment 10 years for raping women. Provision is, evidences of the child should be recorded within 30 days, and there should be a special courts to complete the trial within 1 year from the date of abuse. And if the cases are in the special court, those proceedings should be recorded in the camera. So let's discuss about the another topic, Cyclone Gaza. This we can study in the geography perspective, GS1, climate topic. And why it is in the news? Cyclone Gaza is a major disaster impacted in the Tamil Nadu coast, taken from the Hindu. Here cyclone related to cyclone and tropical cyclones, who give the names for cyclone Gaza, cyclone Titli, like that. And I made the trending topic, that is a 12 minute video that was uploaded in Lakshya by Laexcellence channel. You can type it in the Google and go through those trending topic and briefly about the Gaza and Titli. And exam perspective, prelims and mains perspective, I explained within 12 minutes. So let's discuss another topic, Titli cyclone. So this topic comes under the geography GS1 paper, and the subtopic is climate. So why is in the news? So last month cyclone Titli hit the Odisha coast. So in the trending topic also I explained what is the regional integrated multi-hazard early warning system, and what is this, who given this name Titli, this was name was given by the Pakistan, and what basis these names are given. This and all I explained in the trending topic. So let's solve one question. Cyclone Titli was named by, so here first option, correct option is Pakistan. So let's discuss another topic, that is Suez rocket that is launched from the Kazakhstan. So this we can study from the paper GS3 in science and technology, space technology part, that's taken from the Hindu. So what is this Soyuz rocket? This carries the Russian, American and Canadian astronauts to International Space Station. So in the exam point of view, you have to remember that Baikonur Cosmodrome, that is Russia's space agency from where rocket was lift off. Till 2011, US space shuttles used to go to the International Space Station. After it retired from that, and Soyuz, Russian space rockets, they used to go to reach the International Space Station. Here, geographically, Baikonur Cosmodrome, it is a spaceport. Where it is located in the southern Kazakhstan. The area is leased to the Russia. So, Cosmodrome is the world's first and largest operational space launch facility. Now here in the map we can see Baikonur Cosmodrome, and in the US Kennedy Space Station is there. In China, Jiuquan Satellite Space Center belong to the China. Here we are talking about the Soyuz. It is a spacecraft designed for Soviet space program that is still in service today. So that spacecraft took off recently. Let's talk about the International Space Station. So it is Unix science laboratory in the space. It is like football ground, approximately 250 miles away from the Earth orbit, and it travels at a speed of 17,500 miles per hour, and it travels for every 90 minutes it orbits the Earth. Here we can see the assembling part of the International Space Station. So International Space Station program is a joint project. It is participating 5 agencies, that is NASA, Roscosmos, that is Russia, ZASA, that is Japan Space Agency, ade vidhanga European Space Agency, and then Canadian Space Agency. All some miscellaneous questions. Recently, Supreme Court rejected the state's order plea regarding Polavaram project. Which of the following? Telangana, Andhra Pradesh, Odisha, Madhya Pradesh. Here, Odisha. So, recently, Supreme Court refused to issue stay order for the ongoing Polavaram project. Supreme Court directed both Odisha and Chhattisgarh to seek necessary information regarding this for public hearing. Let's solve some other miscellaneous questions. Sri R. Venkataraman, former President of India, on his birth anniversary, December 4th. Which of the following is true? He is the 8th President of India, participated in Quit India movement, and members of the Constituent Assembly. So all are correct. So here all are correct. In 1984, he was elected as the 7th Vice President of India. In 1987, he became the 8th President of India and served 1987 to 1992 as a president. He has written other books also, Role of Planning in Industrial Development and Relevance of Gandhi and other essays. So, Ravi River. So, this topic we can study in the geography, river systems, and we are taken from the PIB. Why it is in the news? Recently, Cabinet Ministry chaired by Narendra Modi ji, they approved the Saharpur Kandi Dam project that is located in Punjab on Ravi River. So, central assistance is 485 crores for the irrigation and other components for providing for the next 5 years from 2018 to 2022. So, by implementing this project will help minimizing some water which is wastely going through the downstream to the Pakistan. So, this project has irrigation potential in Punjab state and also in Jammu Kashmir. Please remember both the states. Remember Shahanpur Kandi Dam project, that we have to remember. Here central assistance through NABARD under the Accelerated Irrigation Benefit Program. So this would be implemented by the Punjab and assistance with the central government. So the project would be completed by June 2022. Background is, we have to know a little bit about Indus Water Treaty signed between India and Pakistan in 1960 for sharing the Indus water. According to this treaty, India got the full rights for utilization of water to the three eastern rivers. Those are Ravi, Bias and Satluj. So eastern rivers are Bias, Ravi and Satluj. They have full rights. We have full rights to use the water. And also western rivers, Indus and Jhelum and Chenab, they are the western rivers. Under this treaty, we'll share it. We don't have full rights to construct a dam or a power plant construction or anything. Here exam point is some other points here is that Ravi River, its Veda name is Iravati, and also ancient Greek name is Hydraktos. And now we have to remember here is that Ravi River rises from where it is originated from, Himachal Pradesh. So eastern rivers are Satluj, Bias and Ravi, remember, and western rivers are Chenab, Jhelum and Indus. Let's practice one question. Which of the following rivers are not originated in India? So here clearly Indus and Satluj are not originated. Remaining Jhelum, Chenab and Bias are originated in India. So here correct option is B. Here World Customs Organization, why it is in news, and we can study this paper in the GS3 Economy and Fiscal Policies. So here why is in the news? 18th session of Policy Commissions of the World Customs Organization. Meeting is organized by the World Customs Organization.
hosted by the Central Board of Indirect Taxes and Customs, CBIC. It was held in Mumbai, December 3rd to 5th, 2018. Discussed the key issues like trade facilitation, controlling illicit finance flow, performance measurements, challenges of small island economies. Add-on points is World Customs Organization, having more than 180 countries are the members, and it is established in 1952. It is an independent intergovernmental body. It is to enhance the effectiveness and efficiency of the customs administration. So India is the member to World Customs Organization in 1971. From July 1st this year, India take over the vice chair of this Asia Pacific region for the 2 years. Here Supreme Body is Council of World Customs Organization. Then the council sessions are annually held at Brussels. Sessions are attended by heads of the customs and directors generals of all the member administrations. And second highest body is Policy Commission, that meets every 2 years. Headquarters is Brussels. So Kandamal Haldi, why it is in the news? Here we can study this topic in the GS3, Intellectual Property Rights Economy, and taken from the Hindu. And why it is in the news? Odisha's Kandamal Haldi turmeric, it received the GI tag, geographical indication tag. What it is, we will try to know. So here Kandamal we can see in the Odisha, where it is geographically located. So we will try to know what is the significance of geographical indication tag. So this is given for any product that is to give the assurance to the quality and some distinctiveness and its origin of the particular place. With these, other producers cannot misuse the name of that particular product. So let's practice one question. Which of the following true regarding the geographical indication tag? So first statement is, this geographical indication tag is covered under the element of intellectual property rights under Paris Convention for the protection of industrial property. So next, second statement, what is at the international level, this geographical indication tag is governed by the World Trade Organization. That's agreement on trade related aspects of intellectual property rights, that is TRIP. In India level, that is geographical indication of goods registration and protection act 1990, that governs this GI tag. So here all the statements are correct. So let's practice another question. Which of the following true regarding the geographical indication tag? So first here, Shahi Lichi is the fourth agricultural product from the Bihar after Katrani rice, Jardalu mango and Magahi pan, that received the GI tag. And the second statement, Kadaknath chicken meat, that is from the Madhya Pradesh, received the GI tag. So here both the statements are correct. Apart from this GI tag from the agriculture, other arts also from the Bihar, that is Madhubani painting, applique katwa, patchwork and sikki grass, that we will see next. Here we can see Katra rice here, and also Jardar mango and Magahi pan and Shahi Lichi also got the GI tag. Here Kadaknath chicken meat from the Madhya Pradesh also received the GI tag. So apart from agriculture products, there are art forms from the Bihar also. That is, like you can see, Katwa applique, this is the handwork, and also sikki grass craft also got GI tag, and also Madhubani art painting, that also got the GI tag. Next topic is Rajiv Kumar Committee. He is the vice chairman of the Niti Aayog. Union government constituted a 6-member body of this Rajiv Kumar Committee. Why? Because to sell the small and marginal oil gas fields to the private and foreign companies to boost the domestic output. This we have taken from the Economic Times. Thank you friends. All the best. To cover more topics in less time, I just increase my speed. Please comment if you have any doubts.